Hello, Just Too Good here, and the next LEGO idea set has been revealed, which releases November 1st for $25 in the United States, the Woman of Nassau set. This set has been marred with controversy from the announcement of its selection to become a real set. For me, I think something like this is a cop-out if they believe this is made to get more girls interested in STEM fields, which are careers in science, technology, engineering, and math. If they really believe it, why make this a one-off small release LEGO idea set that doesn't appear in places like Target and Walmart? It will have a limited release in places like Barnes & Noble and Toys R Us. And usually with these cheaper LEGO idea sets, they sell out fast and you have to wait for a restock, if it ever gets one. If they really want to get more girls interested in STEM through LEGO sets, why don't you put more female figures in science, technology, engineering, and math in wide release LEGO sets like LEGO City, which they kind of been doing, but not to this proportion where there's four minifigures and all are women in science. Usually you'll get one. The title of the set, in big letters, is Woman of Nassau. It focuses on the fact that this is a set with women only. In a way, I feel this separates the Woman of Nassau from everyone else in Nassau as if they're a separate being. Can we not look at people for the gender and just call this something along the lines of the Stars of Nassau or something? They would have provided a sweet pun, Stars of Nassau. Get it? Anyways, in a way, this research institute did this good because they took out the woman part of the title but kept the same general idea. Again, instead of looking at people for their gender alone, I would have preferred a set with both prominent women and men related to Nassau to show that both genders have worked to build such a great space program. STEM is something that appeals to both men and women, and in the past, where many people implied that STEM can only be a man's thing, naming something Woman of Nassau can give the wrong idea that it could only be a woman's thing. Let's give equal opportunities and show that anyone can get into the STEM field. If it was up to me, I wouldn't have approved this set. You know why? This is an insult to other LEGO idea sets that have not been approved with complex builds that can realistically become a set. The original project's main picture was literally a minifigure collection with small little builds underneath. The official rules say no battle packs and this is a glorified battle pack. And I'm sorry, but come on, those builds are not impressive whatsoever. The space shuttle was okay, but the rest of the builds were so basic, even I could have made them. Again, that reminds me of battle packs where the builds are very simple. The rest are just some walls with some cool prints and a weak miniature Hubble telescope. The actual sets do improve the builds a bit though. The same problem arose with the female minifigure set project in 2014, which became a set as well. I mean, the title is even more blatant there. Of course, LEGO released that as its own set, the Research Institute, which I think is a better title, which had an extremely limited release. Very little were able to get their hands on it, and it now goes for double its original price and even more on eBay. Good job getting these out to the kids you want to build interest in STEM with, LEGO. Again, that was 3 years ago, so maybe this new one will have a bigger release. Only time will tell. My final problem with this set is that this is the third Nassau LEGO idea set. This is the closest to minifigure scale, but not everything in here is minifigure scale. This makes me lose my interest. I mean, the Hubble and Space Shuttle are in the scale of an advent calendar build. The Saturn V was also in some odd scale, and the Curiosity rover was too. One glaring difference between this final set and the LEGO idea set is the absence of Katherine Johnson, which was the minifigure I wanted the most in the original project. LEGO addresses this situation by saying Johnson herself didn't prove to be in the final set, which I completely understand, even it makes me a little disappointed. I'm going to get this set. While I think it's a poor choice for a LEGO Ideas set, I love the minifigures, honestly. And it's only 25 bucks, so it won't set me back much. I like flesh tone figures, and this has a bunch of new prints for them. Anyways, what do you guys think? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Bye.